value of good discipline will always keep you safe from the troubles of life. Nicodemus, follow me to the principal's office now.
A protester from a resist demonstration.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Mr. Deputy Principal, sir.
The values of good discipline shall set you away from troubles of life. Nicodemus, follow me to the principal's office now.
With this kangaroo face,
young man. You are forgiven.
A miracle in 2018. Human commando, our deputy principal, can't forgive someone.
Guys, yes.
Come listen to this.
Young man,
the accusations leveled against you are of an adult person.
Mr. Principal, I don't understand.
Nicodemus, you brought into this school.
You have turned this school into a fertilization factory.
Your seduction knobs have been turned on.
Sir, I don't understand what you are talking about.
Madam Kezia!
Hey! Madam!
You all, have you not been seducing Madam Kezia? A teacher or teaching practice? Young man, your silence is an admission.
Mr. Principal, I insist I am innocent. I don't even know of Madam Kezia.
Madam Kezia, please step forward.
It is true.
Excuse me. Do not love letters to me and put them inside his answer box. He put perfume pictures of himself into my textbook. He also sent a friend request on Facebook and inboxed me romantic messages on my messenger.
WhatsApp.
I don't know how he got my number because he has been sending me adult videos.
What? Nicodemus!
On my WhatsApp, yesterday after class, he followed me and talked to me in a romantic voice. Mr. Principal, he touched me.
Calm down, teachers.
Relax. Here is the evidence.
The offense you have committed is grave and punishable by an immediate suspension.
Mr. Principal, this is a conspiracy by these male teachers who are also interested in Madam Kezia.
Nicodemus!
Who do you live with? Back at home?
Baba Nicodemus, it has been 3 years since you divorced me. You have even denied me access to interact with my son.
Let us operate within the limits provided by the court order.
Court order?
Yes.
Lazaro, when you first met me, seduced me, confused me, took away my innocence as I endured the pain of giving you a son. Was there a court order?
Those are passive memories. My mind is only programmed to remember important facts of life.
Nicodemus is about to see his final examination. Motherly guidance is essential and critical at this point of child development. That is why I brought this Bible to guide him in my absentia. Lift the court order and let me see my son in
school. Milka, you have now become a burden. Court orders are court orders.
That was then. Today I must see my son. Court order or no court order.
Nicodemus, I thought I asked you a question. Who do you live with?
Dowdy.
Dowdy?
Yes. Our houseboy.
What?
Woman, this is the very last time that I will tell you, Daudi is the only authorized person allowed to visit Nicodemus in school, besides me.
Milka, give me the Bible, and I will personally deliver it to the school.
Surely. Where is the world heading? Parental obligations have been left to a houseboy. God of Meshach and Abednego, where did I go?
Milka! Hold your biblical renditions. Let it rise from the Book of Lamentations and heed to the court order. If you dare set foot into that school, you will be liable for 6 months in prison.
Lazaro, how do you allow a houseboy to speak to me like that on matters concerning my son?
I have delegated my parental responsibilities to Daudi.
Daudi?
Yes.
Daudi cannot take the role of Nicodemus' mother.
Sir, your next flight to Mogadishu will be leaving in a short while.
Lazaro!
I have already made up my mind.
Daudi!
I have already made up my mind. I am Nicodemus.
Hey! Daudi!
I have already made up my mind. This penalty committee finds you, Nicodemus, guilty of seducing a female teacher and putting her on unnecessary discomfort. Go! Wait at the disciplinary square as your suspension letter is being processed.
But sir!
Out!
Silence! Silence! We shall take this time, as directed with the new curriculum, to have an open forum between you, the students, and us, the teachers. Talk to me, ask me any questions regarding your social lives here in school.
Sir?
Yes?
Any questions?
Yes, any question will be answered. Yay! Remember, this is an open session, and nobody shall be victimized for speaking their minds out.
Sir,
yes?
What are the consequences of a student found seducing a female teacher on teaching practice?
Especially
when the teacher on teaching practice
is a potential girlfriend
to a teacher on teaching.
Silence! Silence! Before I answer your question, may I know why Antoinette is not in class? Where is Antoinette? Now, everybody, go and look for her. Out!
Nicodemus, what are you doing in the disciplinary square?
Antoinette, these are mere fabrications.
Is it true that you are being suspended from the school? Nick, have you forgotten that I miss my parents?
What?
And we have not resolved on what we are going to do.
What? You mean you missed your period again?
I shall not allow you to leave the gates of this school and dump me in this unresolvable conflict.
Antoinette, my mind is currently confused by the allegations of Madame Kezia. Your period will just come back. Be patient.
If that is the case, then I shall go and tell the loss of my period with the principal.
Where is Antoinette?
I am sure he'll be interested to know how a Form 3 student lost a period twirl in the four corners of
this. Listen to me, please.
No, I will say you forced me.
But you are too willing.
Nicodemus, you confused me.
Antoinette, the burdens that I carry are too heavy for me. I sure am destined for a suspension. But if the principal gets this, I will be expelled. Antoinette, please, listen to me.
Sweet.
What?
Nicodemus, have your passes.
Pass help.
Nicodemus, who is she?
This is Form 4 South.
Form 4 South?
I mean, she's one.
What does she want?
For the last time, Nicodemus, have your passes.
Mixed school, and the discipline of this nature
My policy led to other innocent students.
Mr. Principal, that boy must be expelled from this school.
Nicodemus, are you sure that you are going to come back to this school?
Valerie, it is only but a suspension.
In fact, as a last minute punishment for ruining my life, I will walk in all the classes and request all the girls you ever seduced and confused to sign on this list. And personally, I will hand it to the
principal. Valerie, please.
Please watch.
I did not seduce you. I only have to calculate difficult questions on the logarithm table.
Hey, logarithm again? So that is the same trick he used on you as well?
Nicodemus!
Antonis, have you ever forgiven somebody? 70 times 70 times? You know, the Bible.
Stop dragging the Bible into this. The Bible did not take my periods away.
Valerie, I love you.
You love her?
No, Antoinette. I love you.
So you love Antoinette?
I love you.
Who?
I love you. In plural.
Hey!
I appreciate your stand on this matter, but the threshold of recommending an expulsion to any student is high. Is there any more evidence you have against this?
I am sure if we work in all the classes in the school, we will not fail to get more cases of this nature against this fellow student.
In fact, Mr. Principal, I suggest we carry out a pregnancy test in the whole school. Mm-hmm. And this time round, even the boys must be tested.
Let us not overreact. The boy will be duly punished. His suspension letter is ready.
The disciplinary school.
Okay now, go back to class. The principal is coming.
I have eyes.
Please, leave this disciplinary square.
Not without a solution to my problem.
We shall not leave this place. Today, your rotten mannerism must be exposed to the whole
school. You will cause me more problems. Please, go.
We shall not go anywhere.
You have now formed a coalition to finish me politically.
We are a matter confronted by a common enemy.
Not at this time, when my education is at the brink of total collapse.
A man who has no brains will lie to girls to get favors.
You are now an imbecile.
An incompetent.
I will show you who the incompetent.
Show.
Who do you think you are?
Show us.
Nicodemus.
Guys,
yes.
Mama.
Guys,
yes.
School Spinner Square. Yes.
Fire! Leave her, Nicodemus!
Does the school cockle?
It's growing at the
Silence! What is going on here?
Mr. Principal, we told you, this one is dangerous.
This boy is not going to die.
Nicodemus, you are a rapist.
This is what we call a love triangle.
Nicodemus!
It is not what you think it is.
What is it?
A clear case of self-defense. You see, they wanted to rape me.
Do you look like someone who can be Asian?
Silence! Silence! Students, go back to class and revise for your exams. As for you, here is your suspension letter.
As a rule to disciplinary action, you are hereby ordered to go home and come back with your parents.
I am Phoebe.
What do you mean?
My father!
About your father?
He is a lion, a monster, a wounded tiger, waiting to pounce on his prey.
Young man, your metaphorical expressions will not fish you out of this bond of criminality.
Go home and bring your father.
Nick, what brings you home at this time of the term? Are you on half term?
No, Dad.
Has your asthmatic condition worsened?
No, Father.
Then, what is it?
A letter from the principal.
I hope it is not the issue with your project that take ages to complete. Now, bring the letter here. I said, bring the letter here.
Dear parents, re-suspend.
suspension.
Suspension?
For making sexual advances on a female teacher. You are hereby expected to accompany your son to school with immediate effect. Kind regards, the principal, Premier Academy.
Oh, father, you are not provoked.
Forgive me, Dad. There no, Father. Forgive me, Dad.
Nonsense. Nincompoop.
Father.
Idiot.
Forgive me, Dad. No, Father. No, I'm Dad. No, Father. Forgive me.
Kill you.
Dad.
I told you. This I'm left with Dr. Nairobi.
Dad.
Kill you.
I can't explain all this, Father. Forgive me, Dad. Forgive me, Father. No, Dad. No. No! No! No!
Nicodemus!
And this is exactly what will happen the moment I arrive home with the letter.
Kitana!
You are now beginning to irritate me with your unnecessary pettiness. Take this letter and get out of school immediately.
Please, sir!
Before I change my mind and change this letter into an expulsion letter. Now, out of my sight.
Nicodemus, carry your burdens and get out of the school compound.
The burdens.
Hush. Production.
Out.
Punishment will be to go to the school farm and wash the school pigs. Thereafter, you will come to this disciplinary square and stay here for the whole day. Now, out of my sight.
Welcome! Welcome, my love.
Thank you. Thank you, Doubt.
Make yourself comfortable.
Oh, wow! What a nice house. Wow.
What?
Doubt, you lied to me.
I lied to you? How?
You lied to me that this is your house. Isn't this the portrait of Lazaro, a prominent businessman?
This is my house. And Lazaro, Lazaro is my mentor. Oh. You should learn to trust your mother.
It is okay, my dear. But I hope you understand my fear.
I will understand even better. If you touch me.
Oh. Doubt. Your succulent lips makes my heart go boom. Come, come and kiss me.
What? Doubt? What is this you are doing? In my dad's bedroom? This is total disrespect.
Doubt, but you told me this house belongs to you.
El Chapo.
You are a disgrace. Now, pay for my substance. I want to leave. Stupid. A fool.
What? Doubt. So this is what you want us to do when my dad is not at home.
Nicodemus, these are the processes of making one a real man.
You have disrespected my father. You have ignored the eyes. The eyes that always look at you. You have defied the sanctity of this house. And I must tell my father.
Nicodemus, if you tell your father, I may lose my job. Do you want to be responsible for this?
I must tell my father.
Nicodemus, okay. If you don't tell your father about the small issues in the bedroom, how would you want me to behave in return?
Doubt, I would like you to present me in school as my dad.
Your dad? How is that even possible?
I have been sent home on a very serious crime.
A crime? You are asking me to impersonate your father, a prominent businessman, known to all and sundry.
But he has never been to my school. And nobody knows him there.
The impersonation is a serious offense.
The offense I have committed is grave.
You are asking for
time. I am demanding that you pay for the sins that you have committed in my dad's bed.
Okay. What is the nature of the crimes that you committed?
The girl we seduced. The teacher we persuaded.
I hope you did not admit to it.
But she had the evidence.
Evidence? With which evidence?
The videos. The videos you told me to forward to her.
Wow! Those videos were transparent.
The photos you told me
to post on our Facebook page.
The ones you took dressed up in
my I regret everything that you led me into. I wish I could have listened to myself.
Nicodemus, these are the processes of making one a real man.
But the principal expects me to go back with both parents today.
Relax. I am down. I know your father's walking style. I know your father's posture. Pose and poise. I even know your father's anointing.
Wonderful! Wonderful, Dawdy! You will become my dad.
I will be your father.
But now, my dad dresses in a very unique style. And I think you should copy exactly from this project. Come on. Have this.
Wow. Wow.
Wonderful. You will now look exactly like my father.
Precisely.
Let us go.
Let us go.
Stop it, woman! This is Premier Academy, and nobody is allowed beyond that gate.
Officers, I am the real and biological mother of Nicodemus.
Excuse me, madam.
Your face is unfamiliar,
and it appears nowhere in my records.
I am aware that this is a period of examinations. Allow me to go in and give my blessing to my son.
Woman! If you continue causing disturbance to the peace of this school, then automatically we shall be forced to take serious security measures to eject you.
Eject me?
Yes. Yes.
Me? If you dare touch me, I will scream and let the whole world know that you wanted to rape me.
What?
Here he is. The rock of my life. The mirror of my youthfulness.
Mika! You know that the content of the court order restrains you from moving 30 meters within this board.
Nicodemus is my son.
Your son?
No amount of legal intimidation will stop me from seeing him. Nicodemus, hug me. Nicodemus, embrace your mother. Come on, my son.
Ah! Mika! Mika!
What is wrong? Why did you call me by my name?
I am under strict instructions not to speak to you.
And I am under strict instructions to notify the authorities about your breach of the court order.
He is my son. I carried him for 9 good months.
And I am his mother. I have guided him for more than 9 years.
Is this your son?
Yes.
No.
He is my son. And I brought you for disciplinary procedure.
Sir, welcome. Welcome to the principal's office. This way.
I'm a period kaput. With your kabisa.
Welcome, Baba Nicodemus. We are glad you found time out of your busy schedule to accompany your son to this very important exercise.
We shall first take the point.
Sir, your son has broken the following cardinal school rule.
Displaying total disrespect to the female members of our school community.
In simple terms, thank you.
Exactly.
Your son has mastered the skills of confusing his fellow schoolmates, and on a plate, he has been teaching them bad manners.
Bad manners?
Yes.
Nicodemus. Have I not taught you the etiquette of good morals?
Mr. Principal, there is a big crime.
What is it, Madam Kezia?
A catastrophe of unimaginable proportion.
It is the point, Madam Kezia.
Madam Kezia, our ears are inclined to hear.
I have evidence.
Evidence?
Evidence which I believe is crucial in this case. Valerie, step forward. Tell the principal what you just told
young
me.
Young girl, what is inside the bag you hold?
Bring it here. I said bring it here.
What?
Amphetas!
Mr. Principal! This is a disaster!
Young girl, you are still standing. Down! Who is responsible for this?
Who is responsible?
It is! Excuse me, sir. May I go to the toilet?
It is Nicodemus!
Nicodemus?
responsible for this.
Exactly! Life. Dad! Isn't this character assassination?
Precisely!
Valerie! Tell the principal the whole story!
Sir! After I personally told him that I had missed my periods, he assured me that all would be well. He said that his best friend will bring a solution the following day.
What
sort of solution?
He called his best friend, who promised to bring him a concoction that would make my periods appear again.
Young man, are you aware that it is illegal to have a phone in school?
Sir, this is fiction, wild allegations, words spoken by Madame Kezia to paint a criminal of me. Dad, do I even have a mobile phone?
Clear!
We did a random check in the dormitory and we recovered the phone from his box.
What?
Officers, I must see my son.
Excuse me, madame. Don't make our difficult work more difficult.
And I demand that you move out of this gate, or else we shall take security actions to eject you.
I have not refused to go. I only want to talk to Nicodemus, even for that 1 minute.
Woman, Nicodemus denied you.
Yes. I blame Daudi for all of this.
Woman, I know this is totally none of our business, but who is this Daudi?
Tell us. We scroll inside the phone. And sir, your son has been in constant communication with the house of Daudi.
Daudi?
Daudi is my houseboy. Whoever got the good morals? Oh, my
son. Mr. Principal, this story was taken. A criminal
twist. Exactly.
That Daudi man is an accomplice in this case. Uh-huh. And by all means, he must be brought before this committee.
Papa Nicodemus, call that Daudi man. Now,
Daudi does not have a phone. That I am sure of.
But his phone is on. And right now, he is online.
Madam Kezia. Call that Daudi.
Agreed. Mr. Principal! Mr. Principal!
What is it, gate man? Can't you see we're in the middle of a crisis?
There is a woman at the gate, and she demands to personally speak to you.
Tell her that the principal is not in now, will not be in tomorrow, and will never be in any time soon. Now, out of my sight.
Woman, the principal has just told me that he is not in school now, will not be in school tomorrow, will not be in school tomorrow, or any time soon. In fact, he has been delocalized, transferred, now, off the
court. I must see my son.
Get out of here now,
young girl. Abortion is a crime punishable under the penal code.
But sir, he lied to me.
Mr. Principal, the OCS should take over this case.
That Daudi culprit must be trusted and arrested immediately.
I suggest you call this Daudi man in this meeting, because these matters appear to be more deeper than we can see them.
Sir, allow me to break the pot and spill the beans.
What is it, Valerie?
Mr. Principal, sir, and all the teachers present, the genesis of my problems can be traced back to the man called Daudi.
Daudi? Daudi? How?
Every explanation that Nicodemus gives has something to do with Daudi.
Daudi, Daudi, Daudi. Who is this Daudi?
It is Daudi that convinced Nicodemus to make me pregnant.
Pregnant? How?
It is the same Daudi that convinced Nicodemus to force me to procure an abortion.
This is our treasure!
Papa Nicodemus, call that Daudi man now!
Sir! I seem to have my purpose. If you please already be taken
there. We are in the middle of a very serious meeting that can cause an expulsion to Nicodemus.
Exactly.
Speak very fast.
Sir! I am pregnant.
Pregnant?
Again!
Mr. Principal, is this a school or a maternity ward?
This matters have not taken a completely different direction. Tell me, who is responsible for a pregnancy?
Mr. Principal, this girl is too tiny to become pregnant. The question should be, who infected her with the pregnancy?
Sir! Nicodemus is the one!
Nicodemus, this is too much!
My name is, I am innocent!
My son!
Why are you embarrassing
you
me?
You mean one woman is not enough for you?
In fact, as a student, you're not supposed to be concentrating on women. Mr. Principal, allow me to give corporal punishment to this boy. Bring the girl!
No, Baba Nicodemus. Here in this hall, we do not condone the use of cans. We must get to the root cause of this.
Sir, Nicodemus told me that thou will not see him as a man. If he does not convince me to abort this child I am carrying.
Mr. Principal, as I had said earlier, we must find a way of calling this down.
I agree. He will shed more light and probably offer us part of the solution to the problem that follow Nicodemus.
Baba Nicodemus, call this dowdy man once and for all.
Call dowdy now!
Woman, we have tolerated you long enough.
You have now become a burden.
Yes, a burden.
And we don't need free entertainment anymore.
In fact, your presence here has moved from irritating to annoying to infuriating.
That boy you call your son has rejected you.
Yes.
Has denied you.
Exactly.
Has it not
precisely.
That boy is not your son.
Officers, I know my son Nicodemus. He will come up to his senses once he's separated from that Dowdy man.
Woman, Dowdy or no Dowdy, we want you out of this gate
or else what? You have already denied me access to interact with my son. I will take off my clothes and walk naked to the principal's office.
Ah! Yo! Yelele mama! These are Joseph and Mary.
Woman, just get in.
Excuse me!
Woman, can you see the man that you care with the secretary? The boy, Matt, into this office.
I am an interested party in this proceedings. Therefore, I'm a part of this meeting.
Mr. Principal, disciplinary matters affecting my son are extremely private and confidential.
Wait! Woman, kindly introduce yourself properly and tell us, are you also pregnant?
No. I am Milka.
Milka?
And Nicodemus is my son. My only son.
She is not Mama Nicodemus.
Mama Nicodemus. Mama Nicodemus is the bona fide member of this meeting. As you know, the disciplinary cases affecting her son.
She is not Mama Nicodemus.
Students, matters arising in this office have now become mature. Excuse us.
Not you. You are a criminal.
Nicodemus.
She is a stranger.
My son.
She is mad.
I don't believe. You can say this to your mother.
Mr. Principal, she is probably possessed. Or maybe hallucinating of a son called Nicodemus.
No. You cannot turn your back on your own mother.
Young man, I will ask you for the last time. Is she your mother?
Sir, when I peruse this Form 1 admission letter in his name, the photograph of this lady appears as his mother.
Okay. She is my former mother.
Former mother?
I am the one who led to Nicodemus. After your father had abandoned you and I in the hospital for seven good days.
Mama Nicodemus, is that the case?
This is a mad woman and she is not supposed to be here. Mr. Principal, you will have to choose between her and I.
He is not my husband.
She is not Mama Nicodemus.
And you're not Mama Nicodemus.
Then, who is he?
He is Dowdy.
Dowdy?
My husband.
What?
He didn't hear the plan to take me in bad light. As a result, I was divorced by my husband and chased from my matrimonial home. He influenced Baba Nicodemus to get a court order that barred me from seeing my son. Mr. Principal, for the last 3 years, I have never met my son. I have never embraced my son. I have never even spoken to my son. As you see, my son, he lacks guidance. My son. My son lacks motherly love. He lacks motherly love.
Calm down, Milka. Calm down.
Officers!
Mr. Principal, sir!
I am convinced that this woman is telling the truth. Arrest this man!
Young man, you are here by hand in our custody.
Until we establish the truthfulness of our allegations.
Wait!
What is this?
Sad news!
Sad news!
I am a bearer of sad news.
What is it? Stop holding us in unnecessary suspense.
Let me justify why I took the role of his father. We have a funeral.
A funeral?
Yes. I received it as unconfirmed rumor. But now, I am sure the Baba Nicodemus is no more.
What? Baba is dead?
My husband is no
more. Why did you tell me that my father is dead?
I'm sorry.
Nicodemus.
No, Papa.
I am so sorry. Please, no. Pump fresh energy into your lips.
We are sorry.
My
father.
Son. Cling on to your mother for hope and strength. The shoes that stand before me are too wide. We shall pull through this together.
Mr. Principal, I had to cushion the young mind and take the role of his father. Until such time, I'm sure of his whereabouts.
Baba Nicodemus was part of the committee of infrastructure of this school. Even though he has never set foot into this school, his contributions will not go unnoticed.
In fact, Mr. Principal, I suggest we escort Mama Nicodemus, Nicodemus and Audi back to their home.
We agree.
No, no, no.
No!
Mr. Principal, I suggest to clear this disciplinary action against Nicodemus first. After all, those guards are also in pain. We cannot wish away at all because of intervening circumstances.
Please, Mr. Amos. The boy has just lost his father.
Mr. Amos, have a human heart. We will sort out the issues after we come back from the funeral. Exactly.
Nicodemus, my son.
Cast your burden unto Jesus, for he cares for you.
Mr. Principal, the students and other members of staff are ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proceed to
Baba Nicodemus' funeral.
I decided to make for law. Nick, who are these?
These are my teachers. I am the principal and these are my members of staff. Sir, I have never seen you in this school ever since you admitted your son. See, you don't even know the people who are dealing with your son's education.
How is he supposed to know them?
What?
I have connected him to deal with my son's welfare. Nick, have I ever delayed to pay your school fees?
No, Dad.
Have I not given you enough pocket money here in school? And when you go back home,
you have given generously. Papa Nicodemus, the welfare of your son cannot be summarized into one word.
Money!
My husband, the growth and development of a child requires love and guidance from both parents.
Milka, you know there is a court order stopping you from coming near my son.
Papa Nicodemus, your son is facing extremely heavy disciplinary offenses.
Disciplinary?
Yes.
Of what nature? Daudi, you can deal with this matter. Right?
Yes, sir.
What?
Do you know that several students in the school are pregnant thanks to him?
My son, this is unacceptable.
This is outrageous. Daudi, punish this boy now.
Stop!
Daudi, you are the one who led me into all this. He said that he was training me to become a real man.
Unbelievable. Daudi cannot do that.
Tell the boss.
Papa Nicodemus, students are suffering because of your son's unfit behavior.
My son. Is this true?
No, Mom.
You have embarrassed me. And today, I must teach you how
now. You will be charged with assault.
I am beginning to feel that Nicodemus' problems originate from the lack of parents in his life.
I am a very busy man, as you can see. Today, I missed my flight and all my business deals
I've shut up.
My husband. Doughty cannot replace the world love. Let the mother gives to the son. Allow me to come back and take care of Nicodemus. For right now, he is undergoing a development stage that requires both our love and our support.
Baba Nicodemus, open your eyes and visit. Your son is sinking in the deep waters of bad company.
His adolescence is very hot.
This boy is dangerous.
He is a bully.
A bully?
No! A bull!
Something has to be done, Baba Nicodemus.
Immediately!
Mr. Principal, I have listened to your presentation and I've realized I am the one to be blamed. Please, allow me to make drastic changes in my life.
Dowdy!
Yes, sir!
You are fired!
And arrested for impersonation!
And for misleading students!
You pushed me to separate my wife from my son. I now regret my actions.
Mother! I am sorry! I am sorry, Mother!
Milka, please, find space in your heart and forgive me. I have now realized my mistakes. Please, forgive me. And for the students affected by my son's reckless action, I'm willing to meet your parents and discuss the best way forward for our children.
As the principal of the school, I hereby initiate a teacher-parent-student initiative aimed at listening at our children's problems for the whole academic season.
My heart blossoms with happiness. Happiness of a woman returning with her family. I am excited. Delighted.
Antoinette and Valerie, you'll have to seek medical attention before we invite your parents to school.
Principal and teachers of Premier Academy, I would like to take this earliest opportunity to thank you for guiding Nicodemus. I am sure Nicodemus is in the right hand.
Officers!
Mr. Principal, sir!
For this case, to the OCS!
Dowdy, you are now forced to board the police vehicle immediately.
Hey, officer, Lazaro, where is my salary? Where is my island? I'm not police!
Guys, ignore that and let the musical renditions blare into the air. For this is a sign of a new beginning.
Kakamega! Oh. Thank you very much.